So guys, yesterday in the Mobile World Congress, Huawei launched Huawei P10, P10 Plus and Watch 2. And in this video, I'm going to talk about my personal opinions about all the three products with its pros and cons to help you whether these products are worth or not. So without wasting any time, let's begin. So let's talk about the P10 first and then we'll talk about the P10 Plus and then finally about the Watch 2. So if you talk about the specification of this P10 Plus, then here you get a 5.1 inches of Full HD display. This time it's protected with Gorilla Glass 5 as well as 2.5D curved glass. Apart from that, you get a Huawei's own Kirin 960 CPU with Mali G71MP8 GPU. The storage here is 64GB with 4GB of RAM with 3200mAh of battery, which is of course supported with the quick charging. The phone is running on Android 7.0 Nougat, but again, as usual, the important thing, or you can say the important highlight of this phone, is its camera. Here, this phone has a dual camera setup, which is Huawei's favorite, and it's again supported with Leica branding. Apart from that, if you talk about the camera, then here the first camera is a 12 megapixel shooter and the second camera is a 20 megapixel shooter. It has an aperture of f/2.2 for the both cameras, and of course we have some basic important things such as PDF, 4K video recording, laser autofocus system, optical image stabilization, etc. And if you talk about the front facing camera, then it's 8 megapixel shooter and it has an aperture of f/1.9. Then if you talk about the P10 Plus, then here the screen size is slightly increased. It's 5.5 inches of display, but it's a Quad HD display now. Apart from that, if you talk about the battery life, then it's also increased here. It's 3750mAh in this P10 Plus with again same rapid charging support. Here we have two storage variants. The first base one comes with 64GB of storage plus 4GB of RAM. And the second one comes with 120GB of storage with 6GB of RAM. Again, the camera is same highlight here, and again the camera has Leica branding. If you talk about the sensors, then here both the cameras are same, 12 megapixel as well as 20 megapixel. But the improved thing here is the aperture. Here the aperture for both the cameras is f/1.8. Apart from that, we get the same sensors such as PDF, laser autofocusing, OIS, dual tone, dual LED flash, and 4K video recording. And if you talk about the front facing camera, then it's still the same 8 megapixel with f/1.9 aperture. The phone is running on Android 7.0 Nougat, and these are the things about P10 and P10 Plus. And now finally, let's talk about the Huawei Watch 2. If you guys remember, the Watch 1 was also pretty much successful watch from Huawei, and now again it's a second generation of Android Wear from Huawei. So let's talk about what we are having in this watch. So here the watch has 1.2 inches of dialer size with 390 by 390 pixel resolution. The processor inside of the watch is Snapdragon 2100, which is a watch oriented processor from Qualcomm. Apart from that, we are getting a 768MB of RAM with 4GB of inbuilt memory. Huawei claims that there are three variants of this watch. The first base one comes with a plastic design that is known as normal watch. Then the second classic one comes with a metal body design. And the final last one, again there are two variants. The first which comes with LTE support and the second one comes with non-LTE support. If you are living in a specific country, then you will get a specific SIM card slot for the watch, and otherwise you can use the eSIM in such cases. And as usual, it's an Android Wear 2.0 watch, so we'll get all the latest apps, updates related to Android Wear 2.0 in this watch. So these were the three major products from Huawei in the Mobile World Congress: Huawei P10, P10 Plus and Watch 2. So if you talk about overall my opinion about this product, then I would say again, Huawei is known to be a camera-centric company. They always make dual camera set of smartphones. So again, this P10 and P10 Plus are also camera-centric smartphones. So to be frank, I would say the camera will be amazing, no doubt. But then again, if you consider the overall specification, then I feel Huawei this time at least had done a decent job. The Kirin 960 CPU is a decent one. I'm not saying it's bad. Then again, we are getting 64GB of storage, 120GB of storage options, 4GB, 6GB RAM options, decent display size, and also battery is also great with fast charging support. So I feel this time Huawei has done a balanced job with its P10 and P10 Plus. The phone are overall balanced. Again, there's no specific con that will cause the Huawei company by selling the smartphone. The only con, or you can say the only big question that we have, is about the pricing. As we all know, Huawei strategy, their generally phones are so much high in terms of price, at least in India. So we can expect the Huawei P10 to be launched maybe within 1 or 2 months in India. And if they are launching this phone, then I'm damn sure that the phone's price, even for the base variant, will be more than 40,000 rupees. If you guys remember last time, Huawei P9, when P9 was launched in China, it should be actually roughly launched in India between a price tag of 25 to 30,000. But when it actually launched, it was simply around 40,000. So again, this time the phone's price is slightly higher, and you can say it will be roughly around 50,000. You can say around $700 to $800. So if Huawei launched this phone at this price point, then I feel it will be tough one, because generally we are not, Huawei is not known to be seller in the high-end segment compared to low-end segment. And again, if you talk about the Watch 2, then I don't think so that Watch 2 is gonna come as early in India, because generally the Watch 1 is already selling, and it's not the basically smartwatch sector is not doing that much great, at least in Indian market. So I feel Watch 2 is long way to go, but still considering P10 and P10 Plus, I feel they will soon come to India, but let's just hope that they will come at an attractive price. So yes, that's all my opinions about the Huawei P10, P10 Plus and Watch 2. Do let me know what you think about it. And again, if you guys have enjoyed this video, then I really appreciate if you hit the like button. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below to see some awesome technology related videos, some more tech product unboxing reviews and some tech opinion videos in the future. So that's all for this video, then thank you so much for watching. This is your host Amok signing off. Until then, I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye and take care.